Have you stood in front of your closet, seen plenty of clothes, and yet you can't find anything to wear? I hear you. Today we are going to talk about 5 reasons you might have a closet full of clothes and still nothing to wear. And then we're going to fix that. Hello, welcome to today's video. I am so happy that you're here. We have got a good one because we're going to talk about a problem that all of us face at some point or another when things kind of start getting away from us. We realize we have a closet full of clothes and yet we don't seem to be able to put together outfits, or maybe we don't have anything to wear to a particular event or an outing and we wonder, why not? I have all these clothes. So let's talk about that today. I'm going to share 5 potential reasons for that and some solutions. And so I'm excited to do that. But first, I want to let you know that today's video is sponsored by Skillshare. And you know, I am a huge fan of Skillshare. I have really been enjoying the classes that I've been participating in. You know, my parents, both of them educators, really instilled in me the value of education and of learning. And I really would say I'm one of those lifelong learners. I'm also kind of a creative and I love learning new things. And I actually began blogging at the ripe old age of 54. And then I started this YouTube channel at 56. And you know, when I did that, I just taught myself all that stuff basically by Googling it. So I have a son who's a software engineer, and I'd ask Daniel, how do you do this or how do you do that? And he would always just say, Mom, Google it. And sure enough, there is, you know, information out there, but I am so grateful that Skillshare is a platform that allows me to find the classes that I need so that they can teach me. And they, with the premium membership, there are no advertisements. You can really focus on learning. It's good quality. All the classes have a nice balance of video teaching along with hands-on projects. I love that. Recently, I have enrolled in a class with Sorrell Amore called YouTube Success. Build an authentic channel that's worth the follow. Because you know, that is really what I want here at my channel. I want it to be authentic. I want you to have a reason to follow me. And Sorrell has been teaching me to find my own voice, to find my value, and to remember that this channel is really about you. It is not about me, and it's about bringing you something of value each week. So I'm really enjoying that. Skillshare has provided me with a link so that 1,000 of my followers can have a month of a free premium membership on trial. And I hope that you'll click through that as soon as this video is over. Don't go anywhere, go straight to that link because you're gonna wanna check out Skillshare also. They have classes from everything from gardening to cooking to planning and project management to photography. You name it, you'll find it there. Anything that you want to learn about, I think you'll find good quality teaching there on Skillshare. All right, let's talk about those 5 reasons that you, and sometimes me too, we get to where we have a closet full of clothes and yet we have nothing to wear. Why in the world is that? Well, actually, there are some reasons, and I think if we will think about these things, really get honest with ourselves about them, and then we can rectify them so that we have a closet full of clothes that we enjoy wearing instead. The first reason that you may have a closet full of clothes and nothing to wear is because you're buying outfits rather than building a wardrobe. Let that sink in a minute, because there is a big difference, and I am so guilty of it. Especially if I first go to a shop's website or their catalog that I get in the mail, because that's how they have their pieces displayed for me, right? They have them on a mannequin or they have them in the catalog in outfits. And I really fall into the trap sometime of buying that whole outfit. Then what happens is I end up with an outfit of this and an outfit of that, and then nothing goes together. So I'm stuck with 5 outfits in my closet and nothing else. And so when it's time to go somewhere that I haven't planned for, nothing works together. You know, the solution to that I have found is to really carefully to curate a wardrobe, not just buy outfits. And at my blog, actually a couple of years ago, I did a whole blog series called Building a Wardrobe That Works for You. And if we'll go back to that series and look through that series of blog posts, it really does walk you through step by step how to build a wardrobe that really works for you so that pieces are interchangeable and you have the ability to put together multiple outfits with those pieces in your closet. And that's what we really want. So I have links to that blog series and to some of the posts that I think you might want to start with down in the description box below. So be sure and check for that if indeed you've been buying outfits instead of curating a wardrobe. Now, the second reason you might have a closet full of clothes and nothing to wear is really something I think I've been falling into lately, and that is you haven't identified your signature style. You know, the truth is, too, I think our style changes, it evolves, and recently I've felt my style changing a little bit, and I've got to nail it down, because when we don't do that, we start wearing a little of this style, and a little of that style, a little of this style, and then, once again, things don't work together really well, or we get up on a certain day, and maybe we don't feel that way anymore, we don't feel big and bold that day, we feel quiet, and we feel relaxed, and we don't want to dress big and bold. We went out and bought that big bold thing. So we need to know our style. And you know what? The truth is that it's not just the big icons who have a personal style. You have a personal style. I've talked here before about how really we all wear a uniform, and a uniform tells people who we are and what we do and how well we do what we do. It communicates something about us. And we get to choose that uniform, though. We get to choose the way we look. We get to choose our style, our personal style. If you need a little help with that, I do actually have a quiz at my blog called What's Your Personal Style Essence? And it's just for fun. It's not scientific, but most people tell me it's pretty accurate for them. It will help you decide if you are a classic dresser, or you're dramatic, or you're elegant, or feminine, or natural, or creative, all those things, and just help you to nail that down. But even beyond that, I think we have to put in a little effort to think about, you know, what do we want to communicate with our wardrobe and with our outfits? Now, the third reason that you may have a closet full of clothes and yet you can't put together outfits when you want them is because you don't have the wardrobe essentials. Now, this one I have gotten a lot better about as I began blogging a few years ago. I did learn that if you don't have those wardrobe essentials, then boy, you are going to be toast when you get ready to start putting things together. Now, by wardrobe essentials, what do we mean? We're not talking about the glamorous things. We're not talking even necessarily about the trending things. Wardrobe essentials are those basics, that basic pair of black pants or some other colored pants maybe for your wardrobe, those basic jeans in a cut that you like and that work for you, those basic t-shirts or long sleeve t-shirts or turtlenecks in the winter time, just those really basic pieces that enable you then to take those trending things and put them together in outfits. So we've got to have the wardrobe essentials. If you need to know what wardrobe essentials you need for spring right now or for the summer months coming up, be sure and check out my blog. In fact, if you subscribe to my blog newsletter, you get access to my printed wardrobe essentials list, and there you can download them, put them on your phone, go shopping with them. It makes it so much easier to have those wardrobe essentials. The fourth reason you may have a closet full of clothes and nothing to wear is because you're not working with a tight color palette. Boy, I used to wear just all the colors under the rainbow. I do. I love color, but I also love neutrals. And so I was just buying them all, and my closet was full of them. And so I might have those essentials, like maybe I had long sleeve t-shirts and I had jeans and I had pants, but they were all in different color schemes and they weren't working together. And so I have learned, I really have refined my color palette to, I know my neutrals. I wear brown and black and gray and white. And I know my signature colors. I can rattle them off to you. I wear red and pink and green and blue. And those are my signature colors, and I really stick with them. I don't wear any yellow, I don't wear any orange, I don't wear any purple. Now, if I do wear those things, it's usually like in a scarf or something like that, that, you know, doesn't really affect my wardrobe. Because when you work with a tighter color palette, once again, things are going to work together better. Every time then that you go out and you buy a new shirt, if you're still buying it in your color palette, then it should work with other things in your wardrobe. So I really encourage you to think about working with a color palette. I can give you another link down below in the description box to a blog post. I think it's called How to Select the Colors for Your Wardrobe. It's very simple. I do have several things there for you to consider. You know, I know a lot of people ask me about having your colors analyzed. I did that a long time ago. You certainly can do that. But honestly, I think if you will just ask the people around you, ask your spouse, ask your friends, what colors do I look good in? Or just pay attention to when you get compliments or what makes you feel and look like your best. And you get to decide the colors that you enjoy wearing, but I do suggest you really narrow it down to a refined color palette. Number five, and boy, I've been guilty of this one too, is that you are building a wardrobe, but not for your real lifestyle. I have a tendency to love glamorous, elegant clothes, but I do not have a glamorous, elegant lifestyle. I have a very casual lifestyle. You know, I guess I'm kind of at that retirement age. I still work 50 hours a week, but I work at home from a home office. And, you know, most of us, because of the situation this past year, we're home a lot more, even if we are working. And so our lifestyles are a lot more casual. Just a few weeks ago, I posted a video about transitioning your wardrobe for retirement. You know, really, we do need to make sure that we are adding things to our wardrobe that really make sense for our lifestyle and not that lifestyle that we dream about or that we think we have, but we really don't. Because then when we are actually trying to get out there and live our life, do the things that our life includes, we end up not having the clothes to wear. So maybe do a little assessment there. Think about, am I putting things in my closet that really reflect my personal lifestyle? And then actually I do have a bonus one, number six. And you know what? I think this is one that I preach a lot. And that is simply that maybe you're buying clothes that don't work for your body shape, your body proportions, or your body, you know, your unique attributes of your body. We really do have to be careful about that. There are things that I see on other influencers or YouTubers or in magazines, and I like them so much. I want to wear that thing. But it's not for me, and that's a mistake sometimes too. So we need to be careful about that. So those are five plus one actual, you know, reasons that we may have a closet full of clothes and nothing to wear. But I hope I've also given you something to do about that. In fact, like I said, I've left plenty of links down in my description box below. You'll see the titles of those blog posts that I'm suggesting. Pick and choose according to what you need. And check those out. I really think they're helpful. I try to make those in bullet form so that they're really helpful. The takeaway is really good. I hope you'll visit my blog sometimes too, even if not for any of these others, but just I post Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday there, really trying to offer fashion inspiration, occasionally some beauty too. And I try to do more than just show outfits. I try to really show how to put things together because I think that's so important. Thank you so much for joining me today. Do not forget to check out that link below to Skillshare so that you can get your free 1 month trial premium membership. I know you're going to enjoy that so much. Thanks for joining me. Have a great week.